If you have $10,000 in the bank, make these moves. Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to talk about one of the most important questions I get asked all the time. What should I do if I have $10,000 in the bank? If you're sitting on $10,000, whether you earned it through hard work, saved it, or even inherited it, you're in a fantastic position to make some smart financial moves that can set you up for long-term success. Why sitting on cash isn't enough? Let me start by saying this, having $10,000 in the bank is great, but just sitting on cash isn't enough if you want to build wealth over time. Inflation erodes the purchasing power of your money every single year. In fact, the average inflation rate has been around 2-3, but in recent times, it's been even higher. That means that if your money is just sitting in a regular savings account, you're effectively losing purchasing power every year. So, instead of letting your money lose value over time, let's dive into the smartest moves you can make with your $10,000 to make it work for you. Step 1. Build an emergency fund. Before you do anything else, make sure you have an emergency fund. Experts recommend having 3 to 6 months of living expenses set aside in case of unexpected emergencies like medical bills, car repairs, or job loss. For most people, this will be anywhere between $3,000 and $10,000, depending on your lifestyle and monthly expenses. An emergency fund gives you financial security, peace of mind, and flexibility in case something unexpected comes up. And make sure that this money is easily accessible. Something like a high-yield savings account or a money market account will do the trick. Step 2. Pay off high-interest debt. If you have any high-interest debt like credit card debt, personal loans, or payday loans, use your $10,000 to pay that off as quickly as possible. Why? Because high-interest debt is like a weight that drags your financial future down. If you're paying 15% or 20% interest on debt, it's nearly impossible to get ahead. Paying down this debt is like getting an immediate, risk-free return equal to the interest rate on your debt. So, if you've got credit card debt with a 20% interest rate, paying it off is like earning a guaranteed 20% return. Step 3. Start investing in the stock market. Once you've built your emergency fund and paid off high-interest debt, it's time to make your money grow, and that means investing in the stock market. Why invest? Because historically, the stock market has delivered annual returns of about 7% to 10% over the long term after adjusting for inflation. Investing allows your money to grow at a rate that far outpaces inflation, turning the $10,000 into potentially hundreds of thousands of dollars down the road. Now, if you're new to investing, you don't need to be intimidated. You don't have to pick individual stocks. In fact, I recommend starting with low-cost index funds or ETFs like the S&P 500 Index Fund. This gives you exposure to a wide range of successful companies like Apple, Amazon, and Microsoft without having to worry about picking the right stocks. Step 4. Diversify with bonds and real estate. Diversify your investments. While stocks should be the foundation of your long-term wealth-building strategy, you don't want to put all your eggs in one basket. Consider allocating some of your $10,000 to bonds or real estate. Bonds, while not as exciting as stocks, provide stability and regular income, especially during volatile market conditions. You can invest in bonds through bond index funds or ETFs. And for real estate, you don't need to buy physical property to get exposure. You can invest in REITs, which are companies that own, operate, or finance income-producing real estate. REITs allow you to benefit from real estate without the hassle of owning and managing properties. Step 5. Max out retirement accounts. 401k, IRA, Roth IRA. Max out your retirement accounts. If your employer offers a 401k plan with a company match, make sure you're contributing enough to get the full match. That's essentially free money. If you don't have access to a 401k or you've maxed out your contributions, consider opening an IRA or Roth IRA. The tax benefits of these accounts are enormous, allowing your money to grow tax-free or tax-deferred, depending on the account type. The earlier you start investing for retirement, the more time your money has to compound and grow. Even small contributions now can lead to significant wealth later in life. Step 6. Build passive income streams. Once your financial foundation is strong, consider using part of your $10,000 to build passive income streams. The goal here is to invest in assets or businesses that generate money for you without you having to actively work for it. Dividend-paying stocks are a great option. By investing in companies that pay consistent dividends, you can receive regular income on top of your stock's potential growth. Another option is investing in real estate or REITs for rental income. You can also explore other passive income strategies, such as peer-to-peer lending or creating an online business that runs with minimal input. Step 7. Continue educating yourself financially. Keep learning. The financial world is constantly evolving, and the more you know, the better equipped you'll be to make smart decisions with your money. Read books on investing, personal finance, and wealth building. Watch videos, attend webinars, and stay informed about economic trends. Some great reads include The Intelligent Investor by Benjamin Graham, which is a classic on value investing, and Rich Dad Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki, which offers invaluable lessons on mindset and money. Avoid these common mistakes. Now, before we wrap up, let me quickly highlight a few common mistakes to avoid when you're managing $10,000. First, avoid panic selling when the market dips. Stay calm and remember that investing is a long-term game. Second, don't chase get-rich-quick schemes or try to time the market. These often lead to poor financial decisions. Stick to proven strategies, and you'll see consistent growth over time. So, there you have it. If you have $10,000 in the bank, these are the smart moves you should be making right now. Build your emergency fund, pay off high-interest debt, invest in the stock market, diversify, and max out your retirement accounts. From there, work on building passive income streams and always keep learning. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell so you never miss an update. Let me know in the comments what your next move is with your $10,000. Thanks for watching, and until next time, keep growing your wealth.